some attention, and no vows more important than the ones you're about to make to each other. By entering into this marriage, you're choosing to become lifetime partners, standing together to push into difficulties, and rejoicing in the graces your union brings. So you return to marriage carefully and watch your love grow, and make your love grow to deeper and softer. You face each other, please, and join hands, someone in one hold your throat. Do you, Gregory, take this woman, Linda, to be your lawful wedded wife? Do you promise to love her and comfort her, honor and keep her, in sickness and in health, for richer or for poorer, for better or for worse, and to be faithful to her for as long as you both shall live? Do you, Linda, take this man, Gregory, to be your lawful wedded husband?
I do.
Do you promise to love him and comfort him, honor and keep him, in sickness and in health, for richer or for poorer, for better or for worse, and to be faithful to him for as long as you both shall live?
I do.
And first, Linda's ring, please. Gregory, as you place the ring on your hand, please repeat after me. I give you this ring as a symbol of my love and devotion. With this ring, I marry you. Warm up here. Turn it around. Now that you have joined yourselves together in marriage, may you strive every day to meet this commitment with the same love and joy and devotion that you have today. Please remember that love, loyalty, and understanding are the foundations of a happy and enduring home. And most of all, may you delight in each other's company for your destiny now is a blending of your lives. Inasmuch as you, Linda, and you, Gregory, have exchanged vows of love and faithfulness, and a ring to symbolize those vows, by virtue of the authority vested in me by the state of California, I now pronounce you lifetime partners. That's what you can call.